Sarah here, making a Yarn Lab spinning video. This is going to be a breed-specific spinning video. Again, this is work that I have to do for my Master Spinners Level 1, and I figured I would document it here as well for anyone who is interested in seeing sampling of fleeces from individual breeds. I'm going to go through 10 breeds this year, and the first one that I've done is the very common, I think everyone's familiar with it, Blue-faced Leicester, and this is a fleece that I picked up from the sheep's name was Delta. It's the Little Smoky Blues flock. It used to live in here in Alberta, but was transferred to Saskatchewan back 2014-2015. I picked up this fleece directly from the shepherdess at Olds Fiber Week. You can see that this here is a lock in the grease, sturdy. And this is a lock after it's been cleaned. I washed this fleece the exact same way that I wash all my fleeces, and I will link to that video, not showing this particular fleece, but showing my washing method right here, I guess. Blue-faced Leicester, for those of you who are unfamiliar, is a long wool sheep, and you can tell by the nice long staple length of these flocks. This is actually even a bit long compared to the breed standard. I believe these locks here are about 17 centimeters, 18 centimeters in length. Breed standard ranges from 8 to 15. But it is the finest of the long wools, which is why it is a favorite of hand spinners and knitters alike. It is primarily a white sheep, and however, it does have a recessive black gene that produces this dark brown color. This is an oatmeal produced from combining white and brown fleeces. And the white here, these three yarns were spun from commercially prepared top. But for my breed specific spinning, it needs to come from fleece. So we need to produce worsted and woolen samples. So I've already done that, and I just wanted to show you the process of how afterwards, but you can see here is my worsted spun 2-ply swatch. It's got great luster, it's fairly drapey. I spun this up at about a fingering weight. I think it's a little bit heavier than a fingering weight. And it's not the smoothest worsted yarn ever, and I'll describe why I think that is as I'm spinning that sample. And as I dropped over here on the floor, this is my woolen, which I had to spin at closer to a worsted weight just because you'll see that the prep is a little bit more difficult. But it is a pretty soft, I don't know about next, right next to skin, but it would make an excellent sweater yarn. So I'm going to show you how I prepped directly from some cleaned locks here. And how I prepped and spun my worsted sample and prepped and spun my woolen sample. I'm not going to spin very much of each. I just wanted to demo this for my own records and to share with you. So if you're familiar at all with the ideas behind a worsted yarn, you want to have fibers which are all aligned in the same direction and are all being spun into a yarn, nicely parallel aligned fibers. That's going to produce a sleeker, smoother yarn with less air inside the fibers. It should have really great drape, but less bounce, less springiness, and less loft. And the best and most ideal way in order to prepare a worsted style yarn is to come right from your fiber prep, and it is to do it by combing. Now, these locks are BFL from commercially prepared top. Is a dream, very simple spin from these locks, which you can see are super curly and very long staple length. I found to be a bit more challenging to spin. So I just have these mini combs here. They're from Louette. They were kind of purchased at an introductory price for me. And I'm holding the lock by the tip end, and I'm using the comb to pick the fiber open, as well as lashing it on. So you can see I'm pulling through more than I probably should, and that's going to lash all that fiber on. And I'm really taking my time to do this one lock at a time. So holding it by the cut end and lashing the tip end on. And that, you can see, opens up the fiber and it's going to start aligning things. Now, unlike fine wools, you can see it's not crimp, it's like curly Q waves in these fibers. And so, although things are beginning to be aligned, you can see that there's still all of that waviness. So you're never really going to get, with this amount of crimp in, perfectly aligned fiber coming, not crimp, this amount of wave in, it's not going to be perfectly aligned. I doubt you could comb it enough, unless you took like a hair straightener to it. You're not going to get these curls to come out. So much like curly hair on people, you can brush curly hair as much as you want. You're going to get frizzy, generally aligned hair or wool, but no amount of combing is going to take that amount of curl out. Which is why this is a worsted prep, and I'm going to spin it with a worsted spinning style. But it's never going to be as smooth as some other worsted spun yarns. However, considering the staple length, you are probably going to want to prep your BFL fleece on combs rather than cards, and I'll show you how the carding differs afterwards. So that's enough on here. You can see the locks are well opened up. And I could spin directly from this, but I will transfer it over to my other hand comb here. I don't know if I have the best technique, so I wouldn't take my technique for combing as being gospel or law, but now I have very nicely opened up fiber that is all generally aligned, and it's going to pull out of these combs, maintaining that alignment. And I'm going to spin directly from this comb. You could diz off a bit of top, but I found that it was just easiest to spin directly off of this comb. I also found that it didn't join the greatest, so wherever I joined in a new fiber prep, I got little blips in the smoothness of my yarn. As for my wheel setup, I'm on my fastest ratio with relatively low uptake, which is what I typically like for spinning worsted style. So I'm just using a forward draft. However, it's a much longer forward draft than I would if I was doing a shorter staple length. Spinning something like merino with a forward draft, you're going to really be inchworming. But I believe you want to be drafting something just under the staple length of your fiber. So this is a longer forward draft right off of my combs and onto my wheel. And I just sort of move around where I'm drafting from on my comb until I empty it pretty much all the way out. And producing about a lace weight single here. You could increase the amount that you're drafting with each pinch to increase the diameter of your yarn. But for me, worsted, I like particularly fine singles and would go about increasing bulk by plying rather than by drafting a really thick worsted single. It does tend to want, from this prep, to spin rather fine. And so the other thing about combing is that, you're going to get any shortcuts, any veg matter is going to come out more or less in combing. The short bits will get stuck at the base of the comb. And obviously, the more times that you transfer back and forth between your combs, the more uniform your fiber prep is going to be. So I'm going to stop here, put this aside, I basically, for my worsted sample, I did this for, I think, about 15 grams of fiber, and then I just two-plied, just the way that I would standardly two-ply, wound off into a center bowl cake and plied from both ends. Let me just back a little bit of this out of the wheel, so you can see against my pants here, it's a pretty fine, pretty smooth, but because of the long staple length and the waves and curls to this fiber, the ends do definitely tend to poke out from the yarn. So it's not the smoothest worsted weight yarn or worsted spun yarn you would ever encounter. I probably could be putting more spin in here since plying it back on itself. It's a little bit under spun here. Again, you can probably see this a bit better against my black pants there. But that's how I spun my worsted sample. Just use the combs both to flick open my locks by lashing on, and then spun a worsted style spin directly from the combs. So for woolen, you're going to want to use cards. But if you read up on spinning long wools, carding is really not recommended for staple lengths as long as this, because it just becomes a really tangled mass really quickly. So I employed what I would describe as a carding light method. You always want to start with the card that has the staples across the top. This should be your loading card, and then the one without those staples is your pulling card. That's going to help keep the carding cloth anchored. And what I did is grab some locks and by hand tease them open a bit. And then what I found the most important thing that I could do was, is that rather than loading them on in the direction of those locks, I pop them on going perpendicular to the direction that I'm going to be carding, and that's going to open things up the most, the fastest. And I didn't want to overfill my cards, so I just put a couple locks on. And you can see, because of that long length, most of it's ending up way hanging up the top of my card here. So I only really did a couple of passes to open everything up. And then you could pull this off, roll it up into roll legs, but I just grabbed it off like a cloud. So with woolen style yarn, the key is that you have a nice airy prep with fibers going every which way. And so when I spin this, all of that lovely air and loftiness, the soft cloud of fibers here, is going to be incorporated into my yarn. So see if I can't join it into my very fine single here. For woolen, I'm going to actually come down to my lower ratio, put a little bit less twist into my yarn, and increase my breakband tension, which is going to increase my uptake, and that's going to put a lower twist, loftier yarn together, which is what I did here. And just joining it on like so, and drafting out a thicker single with a my sort of default backwards draft from this lovely cloudy prep. Because this is such a long staple fiber, especially with this woolen draft, this thicker yarn, I really wanted to avoid putting too much twist in. I had sampled some of this fleece way back when I first purchased it and spun it with way too much twist, and the resulting yarn ended up feeling like twine, because It's the finest of the long wools, but it is still somewhat of a larger diameter. I think the micron range for BFL, and don't quote me on this, please look it up, but I believe it's somewhere from like 18 to 28, whereas like some of those merinos, so you could get a fleece that is like 18 and it's going to be as soft as some of your fine wools, but you could also have a fleece that is up near the 28. I don't know what the micron count on my fleece is. I know it's not as soft as some of the merino yarns, but the potential for a higher micron combined, I believe, with the longer staple length, if I spun this with a lot of twist, the resulting yarn felt like twine and wasn't something that I would want to use for much of anything. So, lower twist, and you can see in my worsted, it's a loftier yarn. There's lots of air in here. You can see it's definitely not as smooth. Apply it back on itself and you get something that is really quite springy and lofty. It's never going to be as springy as something with like super, super tight crimp, but it's not as drapey as my woolen, or worsted. Sorry, I'm going back and forth here. Cards, woolen, combs, worsted. They really could have picked words that sounded a little bit more distinct when they're coming up with these, except that it's not like anyone ever sat down and said, this is what we're gonna call the two styles of yarn. There's a lot of history between what goes into those names. Anyways, so I just wanna show you again my finished samples. So this is the woolen one. You can see there's a lot more texture, a lot more squishiness factor. And again, I would have found it very difficult to produce a woolen style yarn that was particularly fine, and so I aimed for something closer to a worsted weight to get my swatch here. And this would definitely make great hats, would make a great sweater, would make a great blanket, probably wouldn't go shawl here unless you were doing one of those really bulky, heavy, kind of winter schlanket shawls. So that's my woolen sample. And then my worsted sample that I was really careful to spin fine and smooth. You can see there's better stitch definition, but there's still some lumps and bumps. You can see I've got a bit of a nep here. And this is likely, like I said, when I was joining in a new combed prep, I found that, you know, you got flaws or variations in the smoothness of the yarn where I was joining in. But you can see that this is something that drapes a little bit more. This would make a beautiful yarn for lace, probably. A beautiful shawl yarn. It's smoother to your skin in this worsted prep than it is in that woolen prep. But you can still see the halo of all those ends popping out. So it's not the smoothest worsted yarn you would ever spin, but it's still quite nice and beautiful. So that's all I wanted to say about that. Just sort of demo, the two styles of spinning that I used for this particular, fleece. That's all for now. If you have had any experience spinning, Blue Face Lester, right from the fleece, right from the locks, please let me know about it in the comments below. And I think the next fleece that I'm going to tackle for my breed is going to be, my breed study is going to be a fine wool. This is my Corriedale cross, and you can just see the difference in the locks here being much shorter staple length, like that's the staple length here. Much springier and much finer crimp than my BFL. So it'll be this Corriedale cross that'll be up next to be spun into a woolen sample and a worsted sample. That's all for now.